yes, it's true that we have to, the consumer needs to be, it's very important for the consumer to become more sophisticated in order to relate to what we're, you know, what we're offering. But I also think it's our duty as, and I'm not sure who, but I can only say as creatives to speak to our consumer in a very specific way. Branding is very, very important, and what these big brands have done, that we talk about these international brands, they found a way to communicate the essence of their brand undiluted, continually over the years. And I think as Nigerian brands or African brands, perhaps when we come onto the scene, we feel like, okay, we have everything going for us. You know, we have good designs, we have good craftsmanship, we're well received. Maybe we feel like we need to compete with you know, the Chanels or the other people. And then we feel like perhaps we need to compete in the way that we brand ourselves. And if we're presenting to Nigerians, we are Nigerians, we live and work in Nigeria, you have to communicate with Nigerians in a way that they understand, that they relate to. And I don't mean that we should dumb it down or make it typically African, but we have to make it, we all sit in traffic, you know? So there are many quirks that are very specific to living in Nigeria or living in Lagos, and we have to address those and reach out to them in those ways. And I feel like social media allows you to do these things in a very specific way. Yes, there is no way on earth that even if I had the budget to spend on massive billboard, you know, there's so many other things I can do with that money first. So I have to think of other ways to reach, you know, our consumer. And Instagram, for example, or Facebook gives you basically Instagram gives you 15 seconds of a free ad. You have to think about that, and you have to think about a way in making those 15 seconds as a video, create something that you can layer upon that will each time send a message about your brand, communicate what your brand is, and before you know it, people will respond to you because it's authentic. And then you get people who will come again, buy, tell their friends, and then you grow up, you know? So I think that's something else we need to think about, the kind of models you choose, the kind of fonts you choose, the everything about it. I try to do all of my shoots in a very specific way. Either I use a specific looking kind of model, whether she's always dark skinned because I'm dark skinned and I can relate to her, or her hair is always her real hair because most of the time I wear my real hair. Just something that I can relate to because that's the person I know best. And so, you know, and that then communicates a very specific message. Oh, this is what this brand is about. And it's easy. So I think we need to look at the things that are available to us free first, utilize them, make the best out of them, and then move on to the other things that, you know, that money can buy.